that I spun the aircraft once, and perhaps the first one to spin, because it's the first course. Ours was the first course at the conversion school. And what had happened was that we were flying instruments with my instructor, and the instructor was a real hot rod. And after about 50 minutes of flight or 40 minutes of flight, he said, "Can I have the controls?" I said, "Yes, sir." Because no one likes, you know, to fly instruments. Yeah. Fighter pilots like instrument flying. So I said, "All yours, sir." But, and I was under a hood, a canvas hood, and I couldn't see outside anyway. And he just put the aircraft into a dive and pull it up vertical and zero speed. And he just touched the rudder, and the aircraft just did a stall turn to one side.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, "Do you want to try it?" I said, "Yes." And I pulled it up, and I sort of, I ended up doing a hammer stall. It just fell back, fell on its back. I wasn't in time to shove the rudder in. But anyway, we did that a couple of times and came back. And then for the solo mission that was coming up, I thought I'd done a hammer stall with the instructor and I could do it solo too. And a very silly and stupid thing that I did, you know, climbed up to 20,000 feet and did the same thing, 5,000 or 6,000 feet up vertically, and shoved the rudder. And next to see the aircraft just, you know, falling back and started to spiral. Mm. It was in a stall, in a spin, with a lot of mud being kicked up, all the dust that had accumulated and stuff was just floating. Everything was just floating up in the air. And the spin recovery, we were told, was just like the T-37. Because mm-hmm. it was a very highly swept aircraft, moderate sweep, about, I think, 47 degrees or so. Mm-hmm. So there's a... It's not like the fighters where they have a very long fuselage and short wings. Mm-hmm. And inertial recovery is required. This is just the standard usual recovery. So I tried the T-37 recovery, didn't recover. Mm-hmm. And I was about, I think, 16 or 17,000 feet and 6,000 feet more to go before I had to eject in a Chinese seat, which had not been tried so far. Yeah.
And it worked, obviously.
Yeah, and I'd heard of a graveyard spin, and I knew where I was going. I was just going round and round and wasn't recovering. And I just quickly tried to figure out what had gone wrong. Had I not applied the controls for sufficient time, or had cross-controlled or something? So I said, okay, let me just cool down, recheck what side I'm spinning, and try again, which I did. And here, you know, throttle idle, rudder neutral, and stick fully back, and opposite rudder, 1001, 1002, 1003, and there were, it just recovered very smoothly, and I made it about, I think, 11,000-12,000 feet safe.
Wow.
So that was the first instance of the MiG-17 spinning in the Pakistan Air Force.
Wow, that is a crazy story.
That wasn't part of the syllabus. Spin wasn't part of the syllabus, although I learned that some of the instructors had been doing it, but it wasn't meant for students. So I perhaps was a unique student to have done a solo spin on the first solo on the MiG.